Hello children, hello students. I hope you are all fine. Welcome once again in our English class. Today we are going to learn our next poem, and that is Kite. The Kite. The title of the poem is The Kite. And it is written by Harry Bain. It is written by Harry Bain. Students, all of us like to fly kites. Do you feel the title of the poem is very interesting? Because you might all have tried your hand in kite flying. Yes, many of you were tried their hands in kite flying. Maybe somebody elder sister or somebody's elder brother, cousin, uncle flies the kite and you have observed them. Student, many of us have different hobbies. Some may have like to play cricket, some may like swimming, but some were interested in kite flying. In India, you know that there is a kite festival in different regions. In Ahmedabad, they fly kites all over in the sky, and that scene was really amazing and attractive. So students, without spending much more time, let's go and let's see some information about the poem and its poet. This poem is written by Harry Bain, and he was a American screenwriter and child author. He born on September 24, 1898, at Arizona, United States. He died on September 6, 1973, at Greenwich. His education, he was graduated from Harvard University in 1922. His work was really exceptional. He was involved in writing scene and screenplay, including The Waffling, that is The Big Parade, and Hell's Angels are his best writings. So children, let's start a poem and let's see. What is that poem? The Kite. All of us like to fly kites. Have you ever tried to fly one? Yes, of course. We have fly the kites in our region, in our surroundings of our houses. Read this poem about a kite as it flies in the sky. Let's see. I will explain line by line to you. How bright on the blue is a kite when it's new? How bright on the blue is a kite when it's new? With a dive and dip, it snaps its tail. It means what? The poet says that when there is a clear sky and there is no clouds, it is very interesting to see a new and colorful and attractive kite. That kite looks very attractive when there is a bright sky. Here blue means sky. When there is a bright sky, when there are no clouds, it is very interesting to see a flying kite. Okay, student, let's see. With a dive and dip, it snaps its tail. Dive and dip means that go into the water with a force and softness. Like up and downs. Like up and downs. With a up and downs, it snaps its tail. Means what? When it is high or when it is flying high in the sky, it moves up and down with a softness and force, and its tail flutters and create a cracking sound and create cracking. I think you all have seen that fluttering of its tail. Its tail flutters as wind blows. Okay, students, and it makes a cracking sound. Look at that next line. Then soars like a ship with only a sail. As over tides of wind it rides. Then poet compare here the ship and kite. Means he compare the kite with the ship. Ship floats over the water. The ship floats over the water, it soars high because there was a waves of water. And here kite also float over the wind waves because of the soft breeze. And therefore here poet compares the kite with the ship. As over tides of wind it rides. It rides means it flows. It goes high up and high up. Okay, students, look at that. Next line. Climbs to the crest. Climbs to the crest of a gust and purls. Then seems to rest as wind falls. Poet says that it climbs high and high as because of smooth and soft breeze. It's so same that ship rides over the tides. You know, students, that when there are tides, means up and downs of water, tides means rising and falling of waves, that up and downs, then what happened? That ship rides over the tides. Similarly, when the wind falls, what happened? It means that wind slows down and kite take rest. And kite take rest means it was unable to fly in the sky. Look at that next line. When string goes slack, you wind it back and run until a new breeze blows and its wings fill and up it goes. It means what? Look at that line, student. When string means thread, which is actually attached to the kite. But when that string loosens, when it would be loosened? When there is a low wind. Then at that time, the kite flyer wait for a proper time for proper breeze and wind. When again wind comes, he runs and tries to fly that kite in the sky. Okay, and run until a new breeze blows. And when that new breeze blows once again, that wind blows, what happened? The wings of that kite fills up with the air and goes it up high into the sky. And again it takes a very big fly into the sky. Okay. How bright, look at that next line. How bright on the blue is a kite when it's new? Here poet used that similar line he used in a starting of the poem. How bright on the blue is a kite when it's new, but a regatta thing you never will see when it flaps on a string in the top of tree. Here poet says that when it goes up again in the sky, it looks very bright and it looks very new. But regatta means torn out or worn out. And flaps means to move up and down. It flaps, it moves up and down as its string stuck into the top of tree. If there were some disturbances like strong wind, trees and wires came across, what happened? That kite stuck and you can't find it back again when it stuck in the top of the tree. And this is the regatta thing, this is the up and downs comes into the kite's life. Here sad ending mentioned by Harry Bain. So students, I think you all understood this poem very well. Thank you for hearing. We will look question and answer in our next session. Thank you.